Today I'm going to be making a diorama with this AT-AT. As usual, I'm just using plaster to build up the landscape for the diorama, and I didn't really have a plan for what I wanted this to look like or anything. All I had was the idea of maybe the AT-AT was blown up and sitting in a shallow tropical area with a beach or something maybe. And I really just kept throwing plaster on and smoothing it out and doing stuff with it till I kind of got something I thought I could maybe do something with. So after a quick base coat of black, I'm going to cover it in Mod Podge glue, and then I'm going to sprinkle this tile grout over it, and that'll give the illusion that it's sand. And you know, I really don't like sand. It's coarse, and it's rough, and it's irritating, and it just gets everywhere. And this is the first time I've ever used tile grout as sand, and I realize it's kind of sticking to itself, so I had to actually dust it off with my finger. And I'm going to cover this whole thing with watered-down PVA glue. And while I was trying to place the AT-AT on the base, I realized that one of the back legs was getting kind of in the way, so I thought a good solution to this was to just make it seem like it broke off. And after I cut into it enough, I was actually able to bend it, and I think this made it look a lot more interesting. After I glued the legs onto the AT-AT, I had to figure out how to make it stand up, but I also kind of wanted it to be like at an angle, so I figured I'd just throw some rocks underneath and then glue them together, and that would hold it up enough, and you wouldn't really notice. It's kind of a lazy thing to do, but it looked pretty okay. And here's the diorama so far, and it doesn't look like much yet, but after you add the water, it adds a lot to the whole thing. And for the water, I wanted a super vibrant blue, like a very tropical, pretty blue. So I went with a sapphire blue dye, and I added that to a two-part liquid resin. And I printed a ring to go around the outside of the diorama. But my dumbass forgot to put something non-stick between the diorama and the resin I'm pouring. So the resin just ends up sticking right to the sides of this print, and there's no way to take it off. The resin is just in there and it's stuck to the print. There's no taking the print off. At this point, I was like, okay, maybe I can just paint the whole thing black and I can salvage it enough to not look like total garbage. So I tried it and it worked for the most part, except underneath the waterline, it still showed the red through the clear resin. And the way I got around this was I just painted a ring around the inside so you wouldn't be able to see the red. And if you're not really paying attention, you're not going to notice it. But there was really no other answer. And now we get to add the smaller details, like the foliage and the rocks and all that. And so I'm dabbing on Mod Podge glue onto the scratches and mistakes I actually made on the beach. And so I'm just going to cover these in rocks and grass, so you're not going to see them. And I didn't want a ton of foliage or greenery on this little sandbar or whatever it is. But I did just want a little bit to give it a little bit more life. And it gives a little bit more color too. It makes it look a little bit more interesting than if it was just rocks. So I tried to make the area between the AT-AT and the sand a little bit calmer, because I feel like the AT-AT and the sandbar would be blocking some of the current and the waves. The waves are going to add a lot to this too, and I'm making the waves out of Mod Podge gloss, and this actually dries clear. And for now I'm just bunching up the Mod Podge and making ripples and trying to make wave patterns places that make sense. And so I tried to make the water a little bit calmer between the AT-AT and the sand because I feel like it'd be blocking a lot of the waves and such. And I'm not an expert in fluid dynamics by any means, but I think the waves look pretty natural by the end. For the bigger waves I'm adding cotton, and this is going to make it look foamier and frothier and whiter too. This is what it looks like before it's all dry, and you see how that wave that has the cotton in it is rising up over the water a bit? That's what I was talking about. Unfortunately, it dries clear, but I actually kind of like it when it looks like this. But after it's dry, it looks kind of boring, so you have to kind of go back in with some white on the edges and highlight the edges and dry brush some of the details back in. And as I was looking at this and about to call it done, I was looking at the AT-AT and I thought, you know, it'd probably have some like algae and some gross shit growing on it by now, so I should add some of that too. And so I'm just putting little dabs of Mod Podge here and there, and I'm trying to keep it down by where the water line is or where water would maybe splash up to it. And it just gets a little round of flocking, and it's all done now. Thanks for sticking around to the end of the video, and if you have a suggestion for what you want to see in the future, let me know in the comments, and I may add it to my list of stuff to make. It's a pretty long list already, but maybe I'll get to it.